The next problem is of finding the generators of Z6 and Z8 with respect to addition modulo 6 and modulo 8. So I will do the first problem. So Z6, we all know, consists of elements 0 bar, 1 bar, 2 bar, 3 bar, 4 bar and 5 bar, where 6 bar is treated as 0. So 6 bar is 0 bar modulo 6. So now we want to find the generators of this set. So obviously 0 cannot be the generator of this set, because if I add 0 to itself, I will always get 0. If I add 0 plus 0 plus 0, I will get 0. If I add 0 plus 0 plus 0 plus 0, I will again get 0. So 0 will not be able to generate all the other elements of this particular set. So if I try that with 1 bar, I know that 1 bar plus, so the first element is 1 bar. Let me take 1 bar plus 1 bar, which is 2 bar. Then if I add 1 bar 3 times, I will get 3 bar, and therefore I will get 4 bar also. When I add it 4 times, when I add it 5 times, I will get it 5 bar, and when I add 1 bar 6 times, I will get it as 0 bar. So this means that 1 bar is going to generate all the elements of the set Z6. So 1 bar becomes the generator of this particular of this group Z6. So 1 bar is generator. Now if I go for the next one, if I try to look for 2 bar, what will happen for 2 bar is that I will have 2 bar once. Then if I add 2 bar with itself, I will get 4 bar. And when I take 2 bar plus 2 bar plus 2 bar, I will get it as 0 bar. So 2 bar, 4 bar and 0 bar. If I add it 4 times, I will again get 2 bar. So this list will go on repeating. So I will again get 2 bar. So if I add 2 bar, see I am writing it here now. So if I go on writing this 4 times, I will again get 2 bar, because this is 6 bar plus 2 bar, which is again 2 bar. So I will not get all the elements of Z6. So this 2 bar will never be able to generate 1 bar, 3 bar and 5 bar. So 2 bar cannot be the generator of this particular set. So 2 bar is not a generator. Now if I similarly do this with 3 bar, what will happen with 3 bar? 3 bar will generate what? 3 bar will generate 3 bar, and 3 bar plus 3 bar is 6 bar. So 3 bar will generate only 3 bar and 0 bar. So this means that 3 bar is also not a generator of Z6. If I go for 4 bar, 4 bar will become 4 bar. If I go on adding it to itself, 4 bar, then 4 bar plus 4 bar is 8 bar, and 8 bar is 2 bar. And when I take it 3 times, 4 bar plus 4 bar plus 4 bar, I will get it 12 bar, which is 0 bar. So 4 bar will also not generate all the elements. It will again generate 4, 2 and 0. So this means that 4 bar is also not a generator. And our last hope is now that 5 bar, and then if you check actually that 5 bar plus 5 bar, and if you take this addition 3 times, and you always reduce it modulo 6 for this, you will actually see that the list you will get is that 5 bar, then 5 bar plus 5 bar is 10 bar, and 10 bar is 4 bar, then 15 bar will become, modulo 6 will become 3 bar, 20 bar modulo 6 is 2 bar, 25 bar modulo 6 is 1 bar, and last is 30 modulo 6 is 0 bar. So this means I am getting all the elements of Z6, and this means that this is so 5 bar actually becomes a generator of Z6. So this means 5 bar is generator, and now this means that I have got two generators in Z6. Those two generators are, first generator is 1 bar and the second generator is 5 bar. So I have got two generators of Z6. Now if you really observe carefully, 1 bar and 5 bar are generators of Z6. You will really notice one important fact, that 1 and 5 are relatively prime with 6. The GCD of 1 and 5 is equal to, I'm sorry, the GCD of 1 and 6 is equal to 1. So let us note that. So we know that GCD of 1 and 6 is 1, and GCD of 5 and 6 is also 1, and that is the reason 1 bar and 5 bar have become the generators of Z6. So this is a direct shortcut that we can do. This is a calculation behind it. So what are the generators of Z6? They are 1 bar and 5 bar. So this is a simple trick to do that. And therefore, using the same trick, if I want to write the generators of Z8, so what will be the generators of Z8? I will write all those numbers which are relatively prime to 8. Okay, now which numbers are relatively prime to 8? We know that GCD of 1 and 8 is 1, and then GCD of 3 and 8 is also 1, GCD of 5 and 8 is 1, then GCD of 7 and 8 is also 1. So this means that all these GCDs are 1. This means that the generators of ZA automatically will be 1 bar, 3 bar, 5 bar and 7 bar. So this is a way that I calculate the GCD, the generators of ZN as fast as possible. So in general, if you have your ZN, you will get how many generators? This is phi of n, because this is phi of 8. So you will get 4 generators of ZA. If you have ZN, you will get phi of n number of generators for ZN. So with this problem is now finished.